This, well, I brought this because I like it.
Well, hang on, you've just...
No, I like it. This is brilliant, but I like this.
So I just finished watching Fallout, and I gotta say, this is one of the best shows that I've watched so far this year. And I can't help but compare it to another adaptation that I watched this year, which was Avatar: The Last Airbender. And they're both adaptations to a show or game, but I'll call them source material. And one of them does it right, and the other one does it wrong. So I'm actually going to talk about Fallout first. Now, again, if you haven't watched the show, please, please watch it, because this is going to be filled with a couple of spoilers here and there. If you don't want to hear anything about Fallout, I recommend you watch it before watching this. But if you want to know what makes an adaptation good, just continue to watch, and hopefully I don't spoil too much for you. But yeah, I watched Fallout, and I gotta say, everything about that show is done very well. It's a silly, gruesome show, but it has its sparks when it comes to writing. It has its sparks when it comes to the story, and even the characters are written very well. Now, with this show, you're taking source material from a video game, which is beloved by many, many fans. And although they didn't take some source material to the show, they've twisted some things here and there to adjust to what they wanted to cater to their story. And it works. It works very well. Unfortunately, there are some things where I'm like, okay. But overall, it's a very well-written story. And I really enjoyed watching it. I binged this thing very, very fast. Usually, I kind of just take my time with shows, but this one, I watched whenever I can. And the main thing I wanted to point out with these adaptations is the characters. Now, the characters in Fallout, they start from one place in the beginning of the story to another place. And the best way to write story arcs specifically for characters is for them to struggle, is for them to have indifferences, and then go from that all the way to the end where those indifferences either make sense or they change. And then in terms of character, where they struggle at first, but then by the end of it, they don't. They understand, they do things right, or all these other things. And that's what I liked about this show, is that Fallout sets these characters up, even the most strongest ones, they set them up where they can change them from one place to another. And that's why I couldn't finish watching Avatar. The difference between Fallout and Avatar, both these adaptations I watched, one of them I finished within the span of days, the other I didn't. And both of these shows actually released all their episodes at once. So the reason why I didn't like Avatar is because when you're doing an adaptation of a show, especially when there are already characters, there's already a world story, but more prominently, the characters are already written for you. You kind of just dig yourself into a box. Like, do we write the characters the same, or do we change it up? And unfortunately with Netflix, it doesn't work. Like, for example, I noticed when watching the Avatar: The Last Airbender, I watched the cartoon of it, and I ain't gonna lie to you guys, it's a very 2000s type of show where it's kind of misogynistic, and it is very written differently. Like, it's written for that era. But this show here, you can tell that they tried to play it safe, and it got to the point where, let's play it safe and let's also give these characters whatever they want. Here's my biggest problem. This is spoilers for Avatar if you haven't watched it. In the cartoon, I actually never watched this cartoon until recently. And I'm glad I did. I'm glad I watched the cartoon before the show, because the show probably would have ruined this character arc for me. In the cartoon, you have Katara and Sokka. Sokka is a very misogynistic character who, like, always goes, women, they aren't good at anything, blah, blah, blah. And that is Sokka's struggle. He doesn't understand that women could be just as good as men are. And Katara, where she starts off as this character where she is struggling, she doesn't know how to waterbend. By the end of the season, you see Sokka trust Katara more, because she has grown in the season. She struggles at first, like she grows in the story, and you see that throughout the episodes. You see her powers slowly come in, and that's what I really liked about that show, is that there are character arcs. They're not great at something at first, they grow. But then you cut to the Netflix show, literally Sokka, they replace this misogyny with just idiocy, and he's just stupid. He's confident and stupid, and it's no longer funny, not because of the fact that he's not misogynistic, but because you kind of forget that he learns from his overconfidence. He learns from it. But in the show, he just looks stupid to make other characters look great. And then you cut to Katara, where already in like within three episodes, she's good at waterbending. When I watched it, I was like, okay, well, where do we go from here? Apparently, she's just good at it now. Like, that's it. We don't see her grow. We don't see her train. It's just, she's good. That's it. Just one episode. She masters the art of something that takes years and years to do. And I guess my point is, when you're doing an adaptation, it's very hard to do an adaptation when you're doing it on characters that already exist. And that's why I liked Fallout, is because we are given characters that are somewhat familiar to this world, but they're brand new. But when you are making adaptation based off of characters that we already know, you kind of are stuck in the box, because as a writer, you're kind of thinking, well, we do need to change it up. Otherwise, people are just going to know what's going to happen. But at the same time, you're kind of like, well, what do we change? And in this case, Netflix's Avatar unfortunately missed the mark here. Like, these characters are still cool, but my issue is these characters are changed, and they're not changed for the better. They're missing an arc, and that's what bothers me. That's why I really liked Fallout. They used the source material that they had, but they changed it where they can put it onto TV. And the weird thing is that Avatar The Last Airbender was a TV show. All they had to do was just make it live action, change little things here and there to make the viewer not expect it, but sadly, they still missed the mark. But yeah, guys, I hope you enjoyed the video. Please give the video a like if you enjoyed it, and please subscribe if you want more content, news coverage from my channel. I try to upload every week, so that way we are constantly flowing with content. But speaking of content, if you want more, please follow my Twitch channel at twitch.tv/RJinthecave, where I stream every Monday, Tuesday, and Thursday at 7 p.m. Eastern Time. And lastly, let me know in the comments down below what you liked about Fallout, what you hated about Fallout. If you disagree, if Avatar was a better show, tell me why you think it's a better show. And yeah, thank you all for watching. Stay safe, stay beautiful. Love y'all.